The manager of the new and improved Boston Red Sox, Bobby Valentine, back on the show. What is different now, Bobby, than, say, 6 weeks ago?
Hi, Dan. How are you?
Hi, buddy.
You're well. New with the team, you know, everyone's playing well. And when they play well and you know, you get, except for last night, you get some starting pitching that takes you into the sixth and your bullpen knows they have a job to do and they come in and do it, all of a sudden you start looking like a decent team. And I think our team is a good team.
But you had to adjust a little bit here without that rotation, two-thirds of your outfield. You know, what role do you play in that, of trying to, you know, a modified lineup and rotation here?
Well, you just try to get guys believing that they can do the job and, you know, not have to do more than they're capable of doing, you know. And if each guy, you know, goes out there and tries to enjoy themselves because they're prepared, and, you know, it's the greatest level in the world, obviously, so it's hard to be prepared for guys like Felix Hernandez, et cetera. But, you know, when you feel like you're prepared and you have the support of the group that's behind you, sometimes good things happen, and a lot of really good things have happened.
Last time you gave a pep talk, a rah-rah speech.
Oh, I don't know if it was a rah-rah. We had one about, we were 33-33, and, you know, we had to get together and talk about it.
Well, give me an idea.
When it was? That was a few weeks ago.
And what'd you say?
Oh, I didn't say that much, to say the truth. I said basically what I told you. Let's just do our own job and go out and do it the best way we can. And, if we do that, good things could happen.
Is it the manager?
And win one for the Gipper, of course.
Is it the manager's job to adapt to the team personality, or the other way around?
Oh, totally. You know, I think this is my, I don't even know how many, maybe 20th year or so. Each year there's a different group of guys that are really comprising the team, and you got to figure out what they need and try to give it to them.
I know you're not asking for this, but I did notice it because I'm always sort of looking at body language, where it seemed like the Red Sox, when Terry Francona was managing, he did get a lot of credit. He did get a lot of mentions from the players when they were doing well. I haven't heard that yet.
Well,
does it bother you?
Not yet once?
Well, no, I don't hear it. I don't hear it as often. Now, does it bother you? Do you care about that? Do you listen for it?
I wouldn't know where to find it. If in fact, you know, where I would look for it. So, you know, I get my good feelings with a hello, a smile, a thank you, and a pat on the back every once in a while, and I think that's good enough.
What's it like on the streets of Boston when you're walking around now, as opposed to, say, I don't know, a month ago?
I think it's pretty much the same. I mean, Boston's an amazingly small town, as you know. Dan, that, you know, everyone knows everyone. And, you know, from the first day I was there in January, the people have been supportive. You know, I mean, I've had a few people when I'm on my bike roll down their window. And I guess you don't roll down your window anymore. Whatever you do, you just push down your window and give me a yell about what happened the night before or what they think might happen that night. But other than that, it's been... You know, I've been a recognizable face that's been welcomed to a new community.
Best team you faced this year is who?
Well, you know, the best team early was Detroit. When we played them, I thought they'd win 162 games. We played them the first series of the year. They had the best pitching, the best bullpen. They had power and defense. Since then, they've fallen on tough times. Other than that, I don't know that we faced that team that is a, you know, just a world beater. I think there's a lot of good teams in the American League, and the look at that we had at the National League was of a lot of their good teams, but I didn't think they were so good that we'd have to fear them.
He's Bobby Valentine, Red Sox manager, joining us, Dan Patrick Show. Got the Yankees coming up this weekend, but you weren't afraid to poke the Yankees in spring training. Was there a method to that madness?
Well, actually, I thought it was the press running with something that really wasn't there. Yeah, you know, I said some innocuous things, you know, like I forget even. Oh, one thing about Teixeira and that I'm not about Teixeira. Who the heck?
I think
I guess A-Rod.
Jeter? Jeter, I thought you said something about Jeter, too.
Oh, he didn't really say anything about Jeter other than he never practiced the play. You know, he had the flip play. We were working on relays, and I said, someone said, did you practice the flip play? I said, no, and neither did Derek. And I don't know if you said that because I saw him on YouTube saying he never practiced it. So I don't know why that was such a jab, you know?
The Boston media, New York media, what would you prefer?
Oh, neither. Just live in a nice little vacuum and go out on the field to play the games and not have to deal with people who have to either describe what happened or make something up about what they wish they saw. But, you know, the Boston media has been, you know, ever present. There's no doubt about that. They're professional people who are who do a really good job at what they, you know, get paid to do. It's a tough world out there, Dan. To try to have the story, you know, in this instant messaging world that we live in, it's tough. And I kind of empathize with some of the guys because I tried to find a story for a couple of years, and it's tough to do.
Ever miss TV?
Yeah. When I see the guys on Sunday night, Dan Patrick and Oral were fabulous to work with, and. You know, Kruk and Ravitch in the studio were a delight. I didn't like all the standing around, waiting around, all the prep work and all that stuff, but who the hell likes practice, right? Everyone likes the game better than practice, and I like the games a lot.
How much of you is an entertainer?
Oh, some of it. Sometimes I think when you go out, you have to hope that people are getting their money's worth.
Because I think there has to be that element that you're in the spotlight, you're being quoted, you're out on the field, you're going to the mound, you're going to home plate, that you have to enjoy a certain amount. You're on stage, right?
Yeah, I don't mind it. And people criticize me for that. You know, I don't run away from an interview. Matter of fact, we're doing one right here. I don't run and cry when people are booing. Or throwing or yelling stuff. I think that, you know, when you're on stage, it's all part of the act.
Well, good luck the second half of the season. Do you give yourself a grade for the first half?
No, because today's, I think, the 81st game. So, you know, it'd be incomplete if it was anything in the first half.
Has baseball tonight said anything that you disagree with or that made you angry? Have any of those analysts ripped you?
I think I've been ripped, but again... I don't hold it in. Let me think. Anybody say anything? No, I don't think anything that's really killed me.
Are you getting preferential treatment?
True. Most of it's probably true. I think early on, from what I gather, they went over on the other side of the edge just to prove that they weren't. And I really thank them for that.
Have you crossed paths with Francona?
Yeah, he's done a couple of our games. He's been in... my office once on the road and his office once at home. And, you know, I've seen him. We've said hi and talked a little, but not too much.
What, awkward? Uncomfortable?
I think the first time he did opening night, I think it was uncomfortable the first night. The second, and it might have even been the third, but the second night I thought it was easier and more uncomfortable for him than me because I don't think he's comfortable being in a shirt and tie and being in a baseball environment. I was pretty comfortable being in the costume and being in a baseball environment.
Well, good to visit with you. Keep your head
down. Thanks for bringing me.
Keep your head down. All right, bud. Thank you. It's Bobby Valentine, Red Sox manager.